region of growth and China in particular. You recently announced a deal with China Aircraft Leasing Company for 100 aircraft, but of course China's growth is slowing. Is that a concern for you, or is it more on the supply side issues within China, relaxations of travel rules that gives this a structural growth still to come?
Well, there are multiple factors that are meaning that China will grow a lot. You've got to remember that they're building airports at a very high rate, and the new airports that they're building, like Beijing, for example, Shanghai, are getting congested already. So we need to move more people in China more efficiently, and that means instead of a lot of little single-aisle airplanes moving the passengers into the big cities, you'll have wide-body aircraft like our 330 regional very efficiently moving people from one city to another within China. I'm not worried about slowdown in the economy.
John, let's come back to overall growth in the industry. I get what you're saying earlier, that there is a bit of global GDP growth, but as we said earlier, orders are already at record levels. What about within the airline industry itself? Is there not now time for a little bit of consolidation? There's a huge amount of oversupply within the industry, and can that not hurt you and Boeing going forward?
Well, I don't think consolidation is such a bad idea. We're seeing some of that. We've always seen that. But there are other phenomena that I think end up under the radar, and that is the rise of the low-cost carrier, and then the legacy carriers forming their own low-cost carrier, as you see Lufthansa announcing their plans to do, and Air France here in Europe trying to do the same thing. Because the low-cost carrier, at least on regional flying, allows a lot of people to fly that otherwise might not have flown. In Europe, we're used to a mature market. In America, the same thing. But think about it out in Asia. You've got a lot of people who are just moving into the middle class. They haven't been on aircraft before, and now they're being told that they could take an aircraft for business, and then when they try it, they like it, they have a little bit of disposable income, they want to take their family on a plane instead of a train. And this is being met. This demand is enormous, and it's being met by these low-cost carriers. If you look at the number of middle-class people in the world, it's going to go up exponentially over the next 10 to 15 years, and they want to fly.